God.
That I have forgiven.
Are the day of the class done? Mataji?
Hare Krishna, you're asking something?
Is the class done?
Going the class?
Yeah.
No, it's about to start.
The mother class is done, Ryan, but Govinda class is not. It just started.
I don't want to join and don't go in the class.
And you can leave.
Hare Krishna Mataji.
Hare Krishna Mataji.
Hare Krishna.
Krishna Mataji. Mataji, didn't we meet on Sunday?
Yes, I saw you on Sunday. It was nice to see you.
Yeah, Mataji, so you go to Baltimore?
Yes, I'm from Baltimore, so I go to that temple.
We just came to hear the lecture, and then we didn't know that Maharaj was coming, so then we got to hear both.
Very nice, right? It was very nice.
Yeah, I got to, because of you, Mataji, that verse I recited, you taught me like the pronunciation, that's why I got to say it. Thank you, Mataji.
You're welcome. It's because
I still remember
you're sincerely learning. That's why you got to
Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Hare Krishna.
Mataji, I can still say it.
Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Okay. You want to share the verse which Amarendra Prabhu said in the class?
Okay. Krishna Punya Shavana Kirtana Hidayanto Seya Vridhani Vidayanti Sahatata.
Okay. Very nice. Okay, let's start with our class today and let's start with our prayers. You both have raised hand. You want to say something, Janvi and Kabir?
Mataji, you raised hand on accident.
Huh?
I raised my hand.
I raised my hand on accident.
Mataji, happy Krishna Conscious Valentine's Day.
Oh. Happy Krishna Conscious Valentine's Day. Who is our Valentine?
Mataji, got this from school. I offered it and then
no, our Valentine is Krishna.
Krishna. And
Mataji, today Jagannath Dithis were going because someone gave it to us until they were in India. And I was sad that they were going. And I said yesterday, please stay more. And they're going to now stay 15 days more.
Oh, very nice. See, your prayers were heard by them.
Yeah, Jagannath is merciful.
Yes, very merciful. Let's start with our prayers, okay? 3, 2, 1. All of you unmute. Om Agyan
Ambitiram Om Agyan 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 Om Agyan
Namaste,
Very nice. So are we still reciting, practicing this verse, right? Okay. Everyone remembers this verse now?
Yes.
Is anyone new to this verse? I don't think so, right? Everyone was there, I think. Okay. So let's recite this all together. Everyone knows this verse now, right? And then we'll go one by one. Okay? All of you please unmute. We will go slow together, okay? No hurry. 3, 2, 1. Everyone said it? Right? Okay, who wants to recite? Academically advanced, Abhinav.
Vidyate hridaya grantis, chidyante sarva samsaya, kshiyante kasya karmani, drista evatmanishware.
Very nice. I'm just looking at these wonderful names. Forward, powerful, perfect. What is it? Mridanga player.
No, it's a power.
Mridanga player. For okay. Yeah. Go ahead, Param.
Okay. Vidyate hetu grantis, jityante sarvasamsaya, vishyante kasya karmani, dishta evatmanisha.
Okay, very nice. Can you say this word again, Param?
Which one, Mataji?
This one.
Kshiyante.
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 Ka and sha together. Sha. Can you say Kshiyante? Yes. Kind Kabir, can you recite? And now then we have Balavinda.
Grantis Chintyante Sarva Samsaya Kasya Karmani Devatma Manishwara.
Very nice. Balavinda, do you want to recite?
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Okay, Vidyate hridaya grantis, chidyante sarva samshaya, kshiyante chasya karmani, drishta evatmanishware.
Very nice. Thank you. Artistic Avikya, go ahead.
Vidyate hridaya grantis, chidyante sarva samshaya, kshiyante chasya karmani, drishta evatmanishware. Thank you, Mataji.
Very nice. Happy Rishya, go ahead.
Krishna Mataji, Vidyate Hridaya Grantis, Chidyante Sarva Samshaya, Shiyante Chasya Karmani, Drishta Evatmanishwari.
Thank you, Mataji. Good. Radha? Go ahead, Radha.
Vidyante Hridaya Grantis, Chidyante Sarva Samshaya, Shityante chasya karmani drishtayet matmanishware.
Very good. Can you say this word again, Radha?
Shityante.
No, there is no D. Kshiyante.
Kshiyante.
Yes, very nice. Okay, anybody else? I did not hear from Dhruva, I did not hear from Sudevi, I did not hear from Janvi. Who else wants to recite? Yes, Sudevi, go ahead. You're on mute, Sudevi. Can you unmute yourself?
Very much. Vidyate hridaya granthas chidyante sarva samshayah kriyante chasya karmani drishti vagvaneshwari. Thank you, Mataji. Hare Krishna.
Very good. Okay. So if everyone is done, then we can move to our next session. What do we do always? First, we always, before moving on to new verses, what do we do?
Memorize.
Yes, we revise, no? First we revise. So let's revise it quickly. Tell me from beginning what happened in this chapter. Who all remember what point?
Oh, Mataji, what happened was like for the Shrinvatam. So Katha Krishna, what happened is that it was about like hearing, and yesterday what we did was Varahadev was Brahma was giving blessings to a blessing or something else to Hiranyakashipu.
Hiranyaksha or Hiranyakashipu?
Oh yeah, Hiranyaksha.
Okay. Hiranyakashipu comes in different story, right?
Yeah, I was just confused.
Yeah. Okay. So here Brahma is blessing him. Okay, let's see what Brahma is saying. We will look into that. Who wants to share? Anybody wants to share any other point? Yes, Avikya.
Also, he was insulting Varaha. So then, there were also...
Oh, you got muted.
He was also talking about how Brahma, he gives out boons, and how, demons, they want the boons for themselves. They don't... Even if they get, the chance to be liberated, they want to live on Earth. But devotees, even if they do get liberated, they say they want to stay on earth and spread the holy name of Krishna. So we learned that difference.
Want to serve Krishna always, right? Devotees. Yeah. So let's see from beginning. Hiranyaksha saw the Lord lifting the earth. So he challenged the Lord that you cannot take earth away from me where I'm in my presence. But Lord kept on ignoring his words. And then he took the earth out of the water. And then the demon kept chasing the Lord. So he got angry and Lord challenged him. Okay, you want to fight with me? You want to kill me? Okay, prove that. And then when that fight scene was going on, right? It is describing some many verses. How that fight scene is going on. Lord is sitting and then demon is also responding. So who came at that fight scene? Brahma came along with his followers to see that fight. And he mentioned how the demon always harassed the innocent ones, right? He first talked about the demon, how he had received the boon from me and how he had become a fearless demon and how he was always troubling the people, especially Brahmanas and cows. That because that was his nature. That's how the demon had become, right? He was always troubling. So this is until this we saw yesterday, right? So this is the new verse. Let's read the translation. Dhruva, do you want to read?
Magic.
Yeah, let's give chance to others also. Let's see if Dhruva wants to read or who did not recite the verse. Janani, do you want to read?
Yes, ma'am.
All right, everyone has raised hand.
Translation. Lord Brahma continued. My dear Lord, there is no need to play with this serpentine
demon,
who was always very skilled in conjuring
tricks
and is
arrogant, self-sufficient, and most wicked. The demon is compared to a serpent. He was poisonous and can be danger to humankind, so no one is unhappy when a serpent is killed.
Okay, so tell me one thing. The demon is compared to whom here?
A serpent.
A serpent.
Yeah, serpent. So let's see why a demon is compared to a serpent. So we all know serpents, they are dangerous to humankind, right? Nobody is happy when we see a serpent. Is anyone happy when you see a serpent? Do we all become happy? No. So that's why it is not like it's the serpents are of various kinds, right? They are poisonous ones, that they risky for human life, right? So there is this pastime of Srila Prabhupada which is mentioned here. Like when Srila Prabhupada was visiting Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati in Mayapur, he was bathing at the Chaitanya Gaudiya Math in 1933. Okay, when was this? 1933. And big cobra came out in front of him. And no one knew what to do. So what happened that time? His Guru Maharaj, means who? Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Maharaj, he said, he was in the residence and from balcony he saw the snake and he ordered some brahmacharis to kill it, to kill the snake. So Prabhupada was clueless. He was a newcomer that time and he was finding it difficult to understand why Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Maharaj is actually giving such instruction and why he was finding it difficult to understand. Because what do we know? That what we should see in each living entity, we should see
Krishna
in each living entity, right? And that's what we have always heard. That's what we have always read. So Prabhupada is thinking why he is giving such instruction, and because we should see Krishna even in the snake, right? So why is he given this instruction? Why he ordered to kill the snake? I just mentioned, right, some of the qualities of the snake. Anyone wants to answer that? Just unmute and answer, because you all have raised hand for reading, so I don't know who wants to actually answer this question.
What was the question?
So why Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur is actually ordering to kill the snake?
Mataji, I think he's trying to kill the snake. Because he wants I think he wants to like kill the snake, because if he kills the snake, no one will get like hurt. Really?
Okay.
Like,
yes, very nice. Who else wants to
say? Mataji, can I answer?
Yes, Avino. Go ahead.
Because snakes will can kill people.
Yes.
And because of that, and because they are deadly,
Srila
Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur ordered the killing of it.
Yes.
Mataji,
I
forgot to say that I think Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur wants to kill the snake because he might the snake might kill like one of his disciples.
Yeah, so he wants to save Prabhupada and that's why he gave that order, right? So snakes, like, they're poisonous and it's their dharma, right? Snakes, you say snakes or scorpions, they're all poisonous and they are a danger to humankind, like I mentioned. And so he wants to save Srila Prabhupada. And snakes are actually, by nature, they are envious. That's one of their quality. You know, when one is very, very envious, too much envy if one has, it is believed that that person becomes snake in the next life. So what we should learn from this, that we should never get envious of anyone, especially devotees, we can always try to be happy for them. Okay, otherwise, the envious nature is like snakes. And it's their dharma that they, snakes usually come to kill the people. And Srila Prabhupada has also mentioned in one of his talks that serpents are, he mentions serpents as death in one of his talks. So they are to be killed. And later what Prabhupada says, he read Srimad Bhagavatam verse 7:9:14 that Modeta Sadhurati Vrishchika Sarpahatya. Even saintly persons become happy to see an envious creature like a snake or scorpion killed. So some people are even envious of, they become so much envious that they become envious of the Lord also. So this is like serpent-like quality, right? So even saints become happy when they see an envious creature like a snake or scorpion killed, and then he felt happy about it. Who? Srila Prabhupada. So Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Maharaj ordered a snake to be killed, and that the snake was very close to Srila Prabhupada.
Mantari, is it a brahmachari?
Huh?
He sent his brahmachari to kill the snake.
Yes. So in there, his mat, there were some brahmachari, so he ordered them. So that snake was killed. So this is one serpent-like quality which demons have. They are very, very envious. So we should always stay away from envy. That we learned today from this verse. Okay, we can always try to be happy for devotees, for our friends, and we can be in the association of such people who are happy for others. So that quality automatically comes into us also. Okay, we can always stay away from these serpent-like people who are not happy for others. Okay, so this is about this verse. And it also mentions that Lord Brahma is saying you're playing with him like, it's like a play. He's saying no need to play with this serpentine demon. So it's like Lord is playing with him. He's having fun time, right? Krishna is playing with him. So that the Lord playing with a demon also reminds us about the history, right? What is the history? What is the history of this story? Do you remember anything?
The
Lord and who is this Hiranyaksha? Yes, Sudevi.
The four Kumaras will curse Jayavijaya to fall down to material world, and that was because Lord wanted to fight with him, and
he's Hiranyaksha is other than Jayavijaya, right? And Lord Varaha is Krishna, who was Vishnu in Vaikuntha, right? So Lord was willing to have pleasure and fight with Jayavijaya, and that's why he made them fall down from Vaikuntha planet. That is all was, that whole plan was created by Krishna. The four Kumaras will come and then they will curse and then they will go to the earth and then I will have a fight with them. And Krishna is enjoying all this when demons are giving him strong competition, when he reciprocates. Otherwise, Krishna could pull them very easily, right? It's not at all difficult for Krishna. And another reason is Krishna gives pleasure to his devotees in each avatar. So by taking more time to kill the demon, we have seen always, right? Krishna takes long time to kill the demon. He never immediately, in a minute, have you seen? He's killing and that's it done. And everything is quiet. And
sometimes it takes years. Like for this, when they were fighting, when Hiranyaksha and Varaha were fighting, they fought for years.
They fought for years?
Yes.
Yeah. The role was
8 days. Mm-hmm. So that's what Krishna is taking long time, and we have seen even with other demons, right? So Krishna is always trying to create an intense situation. So devotees are completely surrendered to him. And that's the intention behind it. The more the fight gets intense, the more devotees show their love for Krishna. Doesn't it happen? It happens, right, in all the pastimes. And so Lord Brahma is completely surrendered to Krishna. And what are the other pastimes we think of when Krishna is fighting with demons and is taking very, very long time, and then devotees are crying and surrendered and they are showing intense love for Krishna? What are the other pastimes? Yes, Sudevi.
Kaliya Mataji.
Kaliya, yes. Yes. Anybody else? Just unmute and say, because you, I don't know who wants to answer.
Ravana? Ravana?
Ravan, okay. So it becomes very interesting, right? The fight becomes very interesting. Sometimes we even think that demons are so strong. Oh my God, they are just giving so much fight, tough fight to Krishna. But it's all Krishna's plan only. Krishna can kill them immediately, easily, but it's not happening. So here is one picture I've mentioned, that with Kaliya. That's a very good example. Even Sudevi said that. That Krishna is, like I mentioned, is looking for that highest intense love from devotees for him. And they surrender unto him. So he creates a situation where he can fulfill all the desires, including fighting with demons. So Krishna gets okay, pleasure even when the demons are giving him strong fight. You see, in this past time, Krishna was in the coil of Kaliya for like many hours, I think 2-3 hours. He was in the coil of Kaliya, and then everyone was so tensed, and Mother Yashoda was crying and she fainted. And see, there's so much love they show for Krishna, right? And Krishna is pleased, completely pleased and satisfied with that love. So he always takes time with demons to fight. And then we saw this also. It's not with the demon, but it's actually against Indra, right? And then how they were all surrendered to Krishna when that pastime happened, when Krishna lifted the golden. And that happened for how many days? He could have stopped the rain immediately, right? Krishna could easily do that, right? But he did not. For 7 days, they were all under one shelter, right? Under Govardhan. And they had the best time under the Govardhan hill. All the devotees with Krishna. That was the best time in their life, right? How many days it was going on and on and on?
7 days. 7 days and seven nights.
Yes.
Week.
Yes. So this is one plan of Krishna of taking time to, you know, fight with demons. And that Brahma knows that. He's saying that stop playing now with that demon. Now you can kill him. So let's see. There are other reasons also why Brahma is saying that. So we will read these translations quickly, okay? Because it's going to be time soon. So I will give chances now from the beginning. Okay, Abhinav, can you read the first translation?
Brahma continued, "My dear Lord, you are infallible. Please kill this sinful demon before the demoniac hour arrives and he presents another a formidable approach favorable to him. You can kill him by your internal potency without doubt."
Yes. Read everything with good attention, okay? So I will ask questions. Let's read all the translations first. Abhikya, can you read the second one?
"My Lord, the darkest evening which covers the world is fast approaching. Since you are the soul of all souls, kindly kill him and win victory for the demigods."
Very nice.
Okay. Mataji, can I read?
Yes, Param, go ahead.
So Mataji, 3.18.27?
Yes.
Okay, translation. A specious period known as Abhijit, which is most opportune for victory, commencement at a mayday and has all but passed. Therefore, in the interest of your friends, please dispose of this formidable foe quickly.
Yeah. Are you able to see with those black glasses, Pam? I'm just joking.
No, Mataji, it's like...
I know, I'm joking. You all have that feature, I think, in Zoom, right? Yeah. Yes, Sudevi, go ahead. Go ahead, Sudevi.
Yes, Mataji. This demon, luckily for us, has come down... Come of his own accord to you. His death ordained Bayu. Therefore, exhibiting your ways, kill him in the duel and establish the worlds in peace. Thank you, Mother.
Okay, thank you for reading this. Let's see what these all these verses mean. So Brahma is actually just praying to the Lord again and again, right? That kill him now, kill him, enough. Now, why is he saying that? We saw some of the words here. Why? Because the demonic hour is arriving, right? Because the demon is praying to the Lord to kill the demon because the night time is approaching. And it is believed that demonic activities are stronger in the night time. So Brahma, Lord Brahma is reminding the Lord. And there is one word here, Abhijit. What does it mean? The auspicious period known as Abhijit, which is most opportune for victory, starts at midday, and it had already passed. So Abhijit time was also getting passed. So Lord Brahma is saying, they're saying that kill the demon now because night is approaching and it's going to be very inauspicious time. So do you think that Lord would be able to kill the demon even when it's dark night time or inauspicious time? Or even when the...
Yes, ma'am.
Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, of course. Brahma is praying to him. Why is he still praying? He doesn't have to do that, right? And he knows that Krishna is nothing is difficult for him. Why is he doing that? Any guesses? There is always a reason for everything, right? Behind everything. If you think, then Krishna will help us to know. Why is he saying that? Because Krishna is the Lord, absolute truth and creator of everything. Nothing is impossible for him, right? So why Brahma is praying? Because Lord wants to test the faith of the devotees and make it even stronger, right? And Lord is pleased by the prayers of his devotees. We all have seen in Bhagavatam, there are many devotees, they are always praying to the Lord and how Lord becomes pleased. And then he reciprocates. He likes to reciprocate to the prayers of the devotees. Else he could easily kill, even before Lord Brahma prayed to him, he could easily kill the demon, right? But he was just playing with him, and then finally Lord Brahma came. See, in this way, it's also glorification of Lord Brahma, right? He also wants his devotees to get glorified because the Lord Brahma is praying now. Krishna is reciprocating and now he is going to kill. So there is reason why Krishna is doing all these things. There are always reason behind everything. So Krishna wants to reciprocate to his prayers. So now Lord Brahma is praying. So let's see how Lord kills the demon in our next chapter. Here our chapter ends, chapter 18. I was thinking that we will summarize it, but it's already time. I don't know, but if Mataji is, Mataji is here. So you all can join Sanskrit class, and we completed our chapter 18. So keep in mind what all we learned in chapter 18, okay? So if anybody asks and you want to share any story with your friend or something, you just summarize one chapter.
Mataji, please go ahead and summarize, Mataji. We have time, don't worry. And today we are going to do shloka revisions from the beginning.
Okay, I just wanted kids to summarize like in 5 sentences, whoever wants.
Take your time.
Okay, Mataji, thank you. Who wants to do that? I will lower all the hands first and then you again raise your hands. I want some new hands, please. Some new hands, please. Krishna Lena has joined. Hare Krishna, I just saw you joined. Who wants to? Yes, Risha, you want to summarize?
Yes, Mataji.
Go ahead, from beginning, okay? You remember how it started? I summarized it a little bit actually in the beginning. Remember? Yeah, just in 4 or 5 sentences. Go ahead. I'll help you if you need help. Go ahead. So So Lord was lifting the earth. Remember, Varaha, Lord Varaha was lifting the earth and Hiranyaksha saw him. You unmute yourself, Isha. Unmute.
Oh, sorry, Mataji. The Lord, he was lifting Mother Earth. And this is one sentence. He was lifting Mother Earth in the
Hiranyaksha saw him, right?
Yeah.
And then what he told him? Was he happy to see that?
No.
So what he told him? You cannot take the earth in front of me, right? In my presence.
Yeah, he was. Yeah. He's a little rude to the tune. Yeah.
Yeah. So what we will do? One by one, we will go. Now somebody else can share what happened after that. Abigail, want to share what happened after that?
Yes, Mataji. So he was calling bad stuff to the Lord, and the Lord, he was just ignoring.
No. No!
For such a long time. And then the Lord was like getting angry, like there's a limit. So he set down the earth and made it float with his energy. And he said, so you made a promise to everyone that you'll come and kill me. So come, let's fight. And
okay. Yeah. We'll give chance to others now. Thank you, Abhigya. Thank you, Rishi also. And then who wants to share? So Lord is saying, if you want to kill me now, okay, you prove your worth. And after that, what happens? Who wants to share? Radha, do you want to share?
Okay, I'll try. Like, I think after that, they have a fight.
Okay.
And then they mostly, and Yaksh calls him like a coward and...
Yes, after that they have a fight. The fight scene is mentioned there, right? How he's throwing the mace and then he's trying to ignore that mace. The fight scene is mentioned after that. And then what happens after that? Who comes there? Krishna Naina, do you want to share anything? Otherwise, we will go to Sridevi. She has raised her hand. Okay, Sridevi, go ahead first.
They had a long fight, but after having the long fight, then Brahma got a little worried. Like, how long is the Lord going to fight? And it's getting evening. In evening, the demons get more powerful. So he told the Lord. He asked the Lord to kill her in action, and then let's keep it the suspense for tomorrow.
Okay. So then Lord is praying to the Lord. Lord Brahma is praying to the Lord, right? To kill the demon. And there are reasons why he says that. Okay. Anybody else wanted to share anything else? Okay, so we completed this chapter. Now I hope that it will stay in your mind and then we will continue from this. Okay? From tomorrow. Okay, so I will stop share and I will see you all next Tuesday and you join your Sanskrit class. Hare Krishna. Thank you, Mataji, Priti Mataji. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna,
Mataji.
Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Krishna, everybody. Thank you so much for such a beautiful class, Nanda Mataji. So nice to hear from you always.
Mataji.
Yes.
Happy Krishna Conscious Valentine's Day.
Very Krishna Conscious Valentine's Day. Thank you, darling. Wish you the same. And wish everybody the same. Okay.
We had Valentine's Day card exchanges at school. I got a lot of candy.
You got a lot of candy? Wow. Which is your favorite?
Hey, Mataji, I had an exchange too.
Yes, Mataji.
Did you give cards to everyone?
Yeah, I gave cards with like little pencils.
Oh, nice. So nice. So you made cards, you got candies. What else did you all get?
We didn't get really anything except candy.
Oh.
On my Valentine's Day, we had a party, and so everyone was passing out their candies, and we made our own little bag. So I made my little bag with a tray.
Very nice. So nice.
We didn't have a party because we're fourth graders, but
So not everyone gets to have a party. Only the elementary kids have parties.
I'm elementary fourth grade, but at my school, fourth and fifth grade don't have it. But the second and third graders had like a very, very, very big party. Mm-hmm. And so did the kindergartners and first graders.
Why is it so? Why can't the older kids have parties?
Because we're older. The fifth graders just get to watch a movie for their party. And then us, we just exchanged a gift and just played a game. That's it. We didn't play a game. We did like a drawing thing.
Oh, that's sweet. Very, very nice. Yes, what does Happy Hrishya want to say?
In my Valentine, that I had a big party. Mine is elementary school, but I don't know, but 15, 6th graders, I don't know that if they had a party, but third and fourth graders and first and second graders, I know they had a party. And at 10:50, before 10 o'clock, we exchanged cards. Like I only made like cards and stick to cool things inside the cards. Like we also made little bags to like put the cards inside.
So it is celebrated only in schools, or you celebrate with name?
I only celebrated at school.
She asked me party. So many people left that there were only four people left in my class. After that, we had we all watched a movie, and my teacher popped up some popcorn, so we ate popcorn and watched a movie.
Oh, nice, Janvi. You had a good time. Very nice. Yes, Radha.
In my school, every single grade gets a Valentine party. So we got snacks, and the best thing that they didn't have the ingredients that we can't eat, so I was able to eat the snacks too. Okay. We also got candy, and we made a Valentine box. We have a contest. Like whoever wins the class competition goes in the house competition. Like all the group of all the grades.
Fantastic.
Competition.
Oh,
nice. For fifth.
Very nice, Radha.
Krishna, and then we also have we also gave Valentine's to people. I only bring chocolates, and we had a lot of fun.
Wow, very nice, Radha.
What our teacher made was she made us make like Valentine's Day boxes.
Nice.
This one's mine. All I could think of.
Wow, that looks cute. I love it. Very nice. So nicely done.
I think mine was like the third.
Divyasiji Mataji.
Yes.
Could I please show you something and then I'll read it to you?
Yes.
Okay. So this is what I did. You embarrass me. Valavrinda is saying to Krishna, either you embarrass me with love or kick me, trample me down under your feet. And if you make me brokenhearted without meeting me, so whatever you like, you can do. Still, I love you. That is love. That is only possible to love Krishna. That is not material possible. Srila Prabhupada lecture SCO 505.1-3, Boston, May 4, 1968.
Excellent. And where is this?
Mataji, could I show you something?
Yes, Balavranda.
I want to show you what I have right here, Mataji. I have these stuff. Look.
Wow, look at that. So wonderful. Balavranda, you read something interesting, right, about love. So where does that appear? Which shloka is it? Is that which prayers does it appear in?
Shastakam.
Good. So you know where it appears. Very nice. Good. Oh, it looks so beautiful, Balavranda. I like that so much. It has lights. Interesting. Anyone else wanted to talk? Oh, Artika, Bigya, what did you want to tell?
So Mataji, for us, like we had like the normal Valentine's Day party, like we did the whole day normal, but like at the end of the day, right before we packed up, like we all got out our boxes. Mine was a penguin, and like we had to like put stuff inside each other's. And I just made like a card, like it was a sort of heart thing, but my friend, she gave like invisible pen and a notebook. And then also at the end of the day, I traded some of my gifts with friends from my other class.
That's sweet. Very nice. Very, very nice, Abhika. Did Krishnanayana speak? She spoke, right?
Yes, not the judge.
You spoke. Where is our Kabir? Kabir has raised his hand.
Mataji, so on Valentine's Day, I was basically the whole day was normal. It's just that at around 11 o'clock.
And you are now in Chase Bank.
No, this is the background.
Okay. So you've now become a banker. Valentine's Day celebration.
There, that's why. You put the background.
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, and then the whole day was normal. So around 11:30, right before 15 minutes before lunch, we took out our boxes and did an exchange. So basically, we put our boxes on our desk, and then everyone puts their Valentine's card or thing inside of the box, and then I have to go around with my things, passing it out to everyone.
Cool. Then whose did you get? Whose gift did you get?
Mataji.
I got it from every single person.
Oh, every single person has to give it to every single person, is it? Okay.
Mataji.
They have to do it. But if they do it, they have to do it. They have to do the entire class. If they do it for both homerooms, they have to do the entire both homerooms. Okay. And I did it for both homerooms.
Both, okay. Very good. Yes. Balavranda, what did you want to tell?
Okay, I was going to say that in my class, everybody passed out like different stuff. One girl, she had goodie bags for boys and girls. So she gave for the girls, they basically got a notebooks with pens, like little mini pens, and the boys got skateboards, and they didn't get diaries. But one girl, she didn't really make her notebook, so she didn't get the notebook, but she got the pen, the mini pen. But I passed out everything to the class, and they put everything in the little goodie bags for what they got from the home.
So, but you got everything, right? You got
everything.
Good. Yeah, we should take care of our things. Yeah, we should.
I got all candies and different stuff.
Very good girl. Very, very smart. Good job. Yeah. Happy Krishya. What did you want to tell?
Mata, this is my second time thing. Talking, but I have to show a few things.
I don't think I'm going to do Sanskrit today. It's only 8:10. So you show that this is. Oh, that is cute. What is it?
Wait, I'll take off my background. This is. I made this.
That's so cute, Hishya.
Thank you. Thank you, Balavranda. And also there's this thing which flies if you leave it. If you have to twist this and you have to leave it.
That's fun. So which one?
This is my teacher.
Oh, Which day do you all like more? You like Valentine's Day gifts, or you like Christmas Day gifts, or you like Halloween Day?
Valentine's Day,
you usually get tiny. On Christmas, you get more bigger things.
Bigger things, yeah. And Christmas also, you celebrate in school like this?
We don't give out gifts.
No, we don't give out gifts, but we do like Christmas parties at school.
Yeah,
Christmas parties are way bigger than the Valentine's parties in my school.
Yeah.
Like watch a Grinch movie or something.
For Christmas, we were supposed to have a really, really big holiday party combining with the other two classes in fourth grade, but we didn't because of this snowstorm. And then one of the classes did it without us, so they just got the party while the other two didn't.
Yeah, interesting. Good. So,
Mataji, we have holidays on Christmas.
Oh, yeah, we have holidays on Christmas. So then you celebrate with friends, relatives, right? And devotees. That's what you do for Christmas. Right. What's that doll, buddy? Is that Jasmine from Aladdin?
Yeah, Jasmine.
You like Aladdin and Jasmine?
I don't like them. I just got it from the big. So she had like a treasure box, and then she gave those to me because her children didn't want them anymore. So she put it in there, and I got it.
Cool. Nice. Radha has a beautiful crown.
On the party day.
Ah. Okay. So do you guys want to do one verse? We still have 5 minutes. So,
sure, Mataji.
What Sita Priti Mataji told me is during our Sanskrit time, every alternate week, she wants us to revise all the verses in Bhagavatam that we have learned so far since the beginning of the Bhagavatam series. Okay, so 1 week we will revise the verses, the other week we'll do Namavali Sanskrit. Okay, like we were doing Krishna Namavali, we were doing, right? So, we'll do those Sanskrit names of Krishna. The other week, we have to revise all the verses that we have learned so far in Bhagavatam. We have learned many verses already, but the point is we should not forget the older verses. And especially the first canto, first chapter, some verses are very important. The first 3 verses are important, and many verses in the first canto is extremely important. Okay, so we should not forget them. So this is an endeavor. Every alternate week, we would try to revise the verses. Okay, having said that, who wants to go for the first one?
Mataji, is it okay if I don't know some because I joined after the Bhagavatam series started?
Of course, dear. So the point is, we are all trying to learn together, right? So if you don't know a verse, you can ask me and you can repeat after me. Okay, if you already know the verse, then you can directly chant the verse. Okay, so we'll do like that so that everybody learns all the verses.
Okay.
Okay. Now I'm going to share the very first verse of Srimad Bhagavatam. And let me see. Hold on. Three participants have raised hand. Yes, that's what I wanted. So we'll start with Balavrinda. Balavrinda, will you be able to chant the first verse? Or do you want me to say and then you will repeat? What's your take on it? Okay, Balavrinda is on mute. Okay, how about artistic abhigya?
Yeah, Mataji.
You'll do it yourself?
Yes, Mataji.
Mataji, can I do the first verse?
Who's this baby who's asking for chance?
Janavi.
Okay, Janavi. Artistic abhigya and Janavi.
Mataji, did you call me?
Yeah, sometime back, but just hold on, okay? So after artistic abhigya, Janavi will recite the verse and then Balavrinda will recite. Okay? Abhigya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Janmadhyasya Yatonvaya Yatata Shrate Svabhignya Swarat Tene Brahma Hridaya Adhikava Emuyati Yatkurayaha Tejo Vari Mridam Yata Vinimayo Yatra Tvisa Gumrsa Ramna Svena Sada Nirasa Kurakam Satyam Param Dhimahi.
Wonderful. So Janvi wanted to go next. Janvi can go now.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
जन्मत्यस्य तोऽन्यत् तरताश्चार्ते स विघ्न स्वरात् तेने ब्रह्मदायात् कवये मोयन्ति यत्सुरया तेजोवारिमिदं यथा विनिमयो यत्रिसर्गो मृषा स्वेन सदा निरष्टकुहकं सत्यं परं धीमहि.
Good job, Janvi. Balavrinda.
Om Namo Bhagavate Tasmai.
Thanks.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Janmadasya yato amrat taradas yadisya vigyasarat. Tere brahma dayari kavaye muryanti yasuraya. Tejo vari vidar yata vidimayo yata yata yata.
Good job. Sudevi. Sudevi. No.
Sorry, Mataji, something went wrong.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. जन्मादस्यतोऽन्वयादितरतश्चातेषु भिन्नस्वरात् तेने ब्रह्मनितायादिकवये मुह्यन्ति यत्सूरयः तेजो वारिमतान्यता विनिमयो यत्र त्रिसर्गो मृष ताम्ना स्वेन सुता निरस्तकुहकं सत्यं परं धीमहि.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Janmadasya tonmayati taratas chateshu bhinyasat tene brahma hridayadi kavaye mohyanti yat surayat tejo varimadam yata vinimayo yatrati sargo mrisha namna svena sada nirashta kuhakam satyam param dhimahi. Thank you, Mataji. Hare Krishna.
Very good. Who is next? Wait, let me scroll down. Happy Hrishya's next.
Mataji, can you put the whole thing like? I want to copy after. I don't know.
Okay, I will tell you. Repeat. Okay.
Okay.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Vatyasya yatonvayam.
जन्मदाय अस्याद यतो नयाद
इतरतश्चार्थेष्व भिज्ञास्वराट
इतरतस् करातेषु अभिजनास्वराट
जन्मादस्य तोन्वयाद
यतो नयाद
इतरतस्
इतरतस्
चार्तेषु
कार्तेषु
चार्तेषु नॉट कार्तेषु चार. ओके, व्हेन सी कम्स मोस्टली इन देवनागरी यू वांट टू डू चार. ओके, चार्तेषु
चार्तेषु
अभिज्ञा
अभिज्ञा
Abhignya. We have Abhignya in the class. Okay. Swarat.
Swarat.
Janmadhyasya yatonvayaditaratas Tarteshva Abhignya Swarat.
Janmadhyasya yatonvayaditaras Chartas Abhijna Swarat.
Nice. Oh, we are running out of time, but I want to finish this verse with you. Okay, so Madhava kids, please bear with me. Brahma.
Tene Brahma.
Hridaya Adi Kavaye.
Hridaya Adi Kavaye.
Mukhyanti Yad Suraya.
Muhyanti yat suraya.
In
ే బ్రహ్మ హృదయ ఆది కవయే ముహ్యంతి యత్ సూరయ
తేనే బ్రహ్మ హృదయ ఆది కవయే ముహ్యంతే యత్ సూరయ
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 తేజోవారి మృదాం
యతా వినిమయో యత్ర త్రిసర్గమృషా
భావ్నా స్వే సదా నిరస్తకుహకం
తస్యం పరం ధీమహి
బ్యూటిఫుల్ సో నైస్ విల్ ప్రాక్టీస్ ఓకే అండ్ విల్ గెట్ ఇట్ సూన్ ఓకే బట్ వి హావ్ టు ఎండ్ హియర్ బికాజ్ ద మాధవ కిడ్స్ హావ్ జాయిన్డ్ సో ఐ విల్ ఎండ్
కల్పతరుభ్యస్య కృపా సింధుభ్యేవచ పతితానాం పావనేభ్యో వైష్ణవేభ్యో నమో నమః అనంతకోటి వైష్ణవృందకి జయ శీల ప్రభుపాద్ కీ జయ ప్రీతి విలాసిని మాతాజీ కీ జయ వృందకుమారి మాతాజీ కీ జయ అగైన్ వన్స్ అగైన్ హ్యాపీ వాలెంటైన్స్ డే ఎవ్రీవన్ బై బై
మాచి ఆర్ యు ఎండింగ్ ద క్లాస్
విల్ జాయిన్ బ్యాక్ ఓకే విల్ జాయిన్ బ్యాక్
ఓకే
మాతాజీ